This microphone plenty hot all the time. We'll be good friends. So I didn't conduct. You could choose to conduct, and one of the things I like about your director is she picks her points in time. That's a little too loud. You hear the feedback, that's too much. It's Mama Bear, Papa Bear, Baby Bear. I want Mama Bear. There you go. She chooses her spots judiciously to conduct. And she's not beating every beat, which is really unnecessary in most ensembles. But what we're doing is listening to the time, the pulse, the beat that's being kept by the drummer. You listen left or right, and you subdivide the time that, in this case, Bob's keeping on the hi-hat cymbals. The hi-hat cymbals, you want to show them which ones the hi-hat cymbals here? For Mom and Dad and
yeah, I'm playing
school board. It's actually somewhat simple, and it's certainly repetitive, and that's a big thing that we need from drummers as wind players. We don't need a lot of oogity boogity, we need a lot of keep it simple so we have a basic pulse to see. Look, the drummer's most important member of the band, and it pains me to say that, but the drummer's most important for keeping the beat, for shaping the dynamics, and for the style. Yeah, we're all responsible for those things. But if his pulse is out of whack, then we're out of whack, and same thing with the dynamics. Let's have Tyler play a little bit with Bob's coaching. I think the single biggest thing I see differently is, other than what Bob mentioned, is don't be afraid to hit the hi-hat cymbal and snare too hard. Don't be afraid. She'll give you $50 for every page that you play nice and strong. She's rich. She has to be. She's a band director.
All right, you're going to count it off. You're going to give us two measures. You always count off long note values to short. You're going to go 1, 2. A 1, 2, 3. You don't need to give us 4. Believe it or not. That means you're messing this up. And you're going to yell it out really strong. You're not necessary, are you? Good.
No one's conducting, and they're playing a steadier pulse, a steadier groove than they were 15, 20 minutes ago. Why? Tyler's being more deliberate. And when you get to that little drum fill where you looked at me, it doesn't matter how many times you do or don't hit something, just be deliberate. If you notice, Mr. Romich, he didn't play a million notes per second, but everything he played felt really good. Same thing with you. You're playing a little bit louder now, isn't it, Tyler?
Yeah.
And it sounds very deliberate, right? I don't know that you can tell before, but there was, as great as this band plays, there was two or three moments where the beat, whoa, it slowed down or sped up a half hour ago, at 20 minutes ago, and now that really didn't happen. Yeah, slightly that one time during the drum fill. So during the drum fill, what do? I would play fewer notes and smack the heck out of the cymbals and drums. You won't be too loud. If you're too loud, she'll be the first one to tell you. But I thought that sounded good. And for the horn players, didn't that feel a little bit more secure having them play louder? Again, you don't need to agree with me, I'm leaving soon. But it should have felt, as a horn player, you're thinking, okay, I'm counting with these beats. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, over and over. And if that's insecure, like one, two, where's beat three? It kind of stuttered for a second. And that makes us anxious, and that leads to our error in production. So let's take a look at the first tune we're going to swing. How about a hand for Tyler and the band?